सप्ताशरथ मारूढ़ अरुण सारथि सदा श्वेत पद्म धरम देवम त्वं सूर्यं प्रणमाम्यहम् बंदूक पुष्प संकाशम सहार कुंडल भूषणम एक चक्र धरम देवम त्वं सूर्यं प्रणमाम्यहम् लोहित वर्ण संकाशम सर्वलोक पितामहम् सर्वव्याधि हरं देवम त्वं सूर्यं प्रणमाम्यहम्
Coming down the Himalayan slopes on the banks of the river Ravi, as it flows through the south of Jammu and Kashmir, stands modern-day Basoli, a sleepy town of flat-roofed houses and rising temples. Earlier known as Vishwasthali, this was once a flourishing pilgrimage and trade center. Earlier, the magnificent palace of the Pal dynasty dominated the whole landscape. It was during the reign of Raja Kirpal Pal that this small kingdom made a big impression on the cultural map of India as home of one of the major schools of miniature painting. Raja Kirpal Pal was crowned king in 1678. One of the Raja's favorite works was the Rasmanjari, a long poem on romantic love written in the 15th century by Bhanudat of Bihar. The Raja commissioned master painter Devidas of Noorpur to illustrate the Rasmanjari. The original records of Kirpal Pal's court are preserved to this day with the Raj Joshi, or the chief priest of Basoli. The Sanskrit text written on palm leaf records that Devidas completed the assignment in 1693. This 300-year-old horoscope of Raja Kirpal Pal traces the descent of the Basoli kings from the Pandavas, heroes of the great Indian epic, the Mahabharata. Painting is of Raja Kirpal Pal, and this Basoli painting features the seven sacred rishis of Hinduism. The painter must have based the figures, their postures and gestures on sadhus and fakirs he had seen. Raja Kirpal Pal was a devotee of Vishnu, and Vaishnavism was the central inspiration of Basoli paintings. In Jammu and Kashmir, Hindu philosophy played a special role in influencing Islamic Sufism. Beautiful Jammu and Kashmir was the birthplace of many scholarly works in Sanskrit. Indeed, at one time, the Kashmir Valley rivaled Banaras as a center of learning. Here, sage Patanjali wrote the Yoga Sutras, the earliest systematic study of yoga. Bharat Muni wrote the Natya Shastra in the 2nd century BC. This ancient classic on drama, dance, music and poetry continues to inspire artists even today. The 17th century saw a revival of Vaishnavism in North India. Vaishnavism believes that man achieves liberation through loving surrender to God. For centuries, Hindus and Muslims in Jammu and Kashmir lived harmoniously together, one influencing the other. Islamic Sufis here are unique in that they too seek to renounce the physical world and surrender themselves totally to the divine. So close was the relation between Hinduism and Sufism that the Sufis here were known as Muslim rishis. Among the most famous was Sheikh Nuruddin, lovingly known to all as Nand Rishi. Many Kashmiri Hindus and Muslims became his disciples and till today offer flowers and prayers at his shrine at Charare Sharif. The Sufis believe their mystical songs or Sufiana Kalam help raise the spirit to a state of divine ecstasy. I went to Medina and prayed. But my heart was not cleansed, the dirt remained. Break all chains with worldly things. Build a masjid in your heart and experience God there. Many saints came to the Kashmir Valley from Central Asia to propagate Sufism. Among the earliest of such preachers was Hazrat Amir-e-Kabir Shah-e Hamdan. Mughal Prince Dara Shikoh, who was deeply interested in Sufism, built the shrine for the Sufi saint Makhdoom Sahib. In 1649, he built this memorial for his Sufi tutor Akhund Mullah Shah, who was the scholar of Hindu philosophy too. Dastagir Sahib was built in 1767 on the advice of the great Sufi saint Sakhi Shah Muhammad Fazil. Travelling here from Baghdad, it was this saint who propagated the Qadri sect in Kashmir. Is the shrine of Akhnoon Shah, another Sufi saint. In the 17th century, Prince Dara Shikoh built the Pari Mahal, a seminary for Sufi mystics. Century, King Sangram Pal of Basoli visited the Mughal court and thus began a lasting friendship with Prince Dara Shikoh. Puritanical Aurangzeb, who despised all things artistic, ascended the Delhi throne in 1658. Artists who fled the Mughal court were given cultural protection by Basoli. Raja Kirpal Pal was Sangram Pal's nephew. He commissioned well-known painter Devi Das to illustrate Bhanudat's Rasmanjari poem. Both poet and painter begin their works with homage to Lord Shiva.
दारो मार रे जिन मुझे डाले जाप पर को दारो मार रे जिन मुझे
The 138 vibrant verses of the Rasmanjari explore the Shringar Ras, or the flavor of love in all its nuances. Shringar is considered the king of all the rasas. Rasmanjari has a unique place in Sanskrit Shringar poetry as it focuses on the subject of Nayak Nayika Bhed, or classification of heroes and heroines. According to their situation in love, there are 8 main types of Nayikas. Such classification of lovers has its roots in Bharat Muni's Natyashastra, which is the world's oldest surviving text on all aspects of drama and stagecraft. The focus in both poem and paintings is the Nayika or heroine, rather than the Nayak or hero. Krishna appears as the divine lover in some paintings. Lord Shiva and Ram also feature in Rasmanjari paintings. Vasaksacha, Nayika waits for her lover. Telling stories, she lulls her in-laws to sleep. She covers the cages of the birds and sends the maidservant out. Then, putting out the lamp with the shake of her sari, she lies quietly on the bed. Now, her lover approaches with bated breath for the sweet rites of love. The maid tells Radha about Krishna sleeping. Youthful Nayika. Oh, lotus-eyed beauty. Who will be the fortunate one to leave nail marks on your bosom? Madhya Swadhin Patika. She who is devotedly loved. Though I refuse his advances, my sweetheart pursues me. What should I do, O Sakhi? Vipralabdha, the neglected Nayika. The thundering black clouds roar like the angry buffalo of Yama, the god of death. Trampling the serpent of patience, crossing the river of modesty, she seeks her lover. Not finding him there, she is heartbroken. Finding him there, she is heartbroken. Arkia Swadhinapatika, she who is devotedly loved. O Sakhi, my lover adores me, chases me, ignoring other doe-eyed damsels whose ornaments tinkle invitingly. Naika preparing for her lover. She coos like a dove for her lover, stretches her lotus-like hands. Naika, whose husband is away. As Lord Krishna departs, the Naika removes her garland of lotus petals. Her armlet drops to her wrist as if to feel her pulse. Depicts in human form Rag Vinod, a rag of pleasure. Rag Mishthan and Rag Vinod were particularly popular among hill musicians. Mugdhavasika. The Rati Priya Nayaka never tires of love making. In Bhanudat's classification, this type of Nayika worships the ground her Nayak walks on. Left alone after a quarrel with Nayak. Oh, Sakhi, a sign of lotus on my palm.
Jupiter points to good fortune in my horoscope. Luck lines crisscross my forehead. All these auspicious signs, yet I lose my temper. Cursed is my life, my love, my youth. कलहांतरिता symbolizes the spirit of Hindu-Muslim harmony. This style of painting marries the vibrant folk art of the hills based on Hindu mythology with the fine brush painting techniques of the Mughal artists. The paintings are bathed in warm and vibrant colors which are still as vivid today. The painters used to grind vegetable colors on stone slabs for even a year to achieve a single perfect pigment. Temple sindoor was used for orange and the lapis lazuli stone for indigo. Real gold powder was used to create the gold tints and some used beetle wing cases for painting jewelry. The paintings were done on handmade paper made from jute, bamboo, vegetables and silk. Samanya Abhisarika, courtesan goes out to seek her lover. Her bosom heaves, her upper garments flutter, gold ornaments dangle, her gait charms. There she goes, the Nayika, to meet her beloved in his bower. Lambha, Sakhi complains to Nayak. Madhya Proshita Bhartrika, the husband is away. प्रौढ़ा स्वधीन पटिका मुक्त प्रोषिता Radha takes advice from a friend. Radha सामान्य विप्रलब था द नेग्लेक्टेड कोर्टिसन। Comes out to meet Krishna. Sakhi instructs Nayika that Krishna waits outside. Agyat Yovana Mugdha. Youth springs a surprise. Her moon-like face, large eyes, reflect in the pool. She brushes away the flowers from her hair. Her hips weigh heavy. Innocently, she asks herself, can it be that I'm tired? Can it just be tiredness? Talks to Sakhi. Praudha Abhisarika. Nayika seeking her lover. Her bosom heaves. Her feet as tender as new leaves. She ventures into the night, riding the chariot of longing and desire. Parkiya Kalahantarita. Nayika estranged by quarrel. Vivekananda and friend. Prodha Vasak Saja, bed ready, she waits for her lover. The doe-eyed Nayika adorns herself. Her fair body shimmering with gold and Ketaki flowers sets the chamber aglow. The Nayika expresses the Rati Bhav, or the feeling of love, with delicate movements of her eyes, eyebrows and limbs. She whispers sweet words of love. Bhavas, or feelings too, were classified by Bharat Muni in the Natya Shastra. Vishnu sleeping on Sheshnag. Madhya Abhisarika. Madana Sakhi. Sakhi applying sandal paste on Nayika's bosom. Parihas. The nine avatars of Vishnu are seen in the background of the painting. Vaishnavism was a central inspiration for Basoli painting. Abhisarika, Nayika seeks her lover. Mukta Navodha, newly wedded Nayika. Locked in loving arms, the new bride struggles to free herself. To win her over is like trying to hold quicksilver steady on the palm. Dheera Dheera Jyeshta Kanishtha. The cunning Nayak offers two jewels, one for the elder and the other for her. Her, the one whose bosom he enjoys caressing. Nayika and Krishna. Virha Nivedan. the Nayika is separated from her lover. Swadheen Patika, the Nayika who is devotedly loved. Mugdha Vasak Sajja, the Nayika awaits her lover, bed prepared. The newlywed Nayika watches preparations to cater to her lover's desire. A sakhi strings a necklace of pearls, another attaches a girdle. Abhisarika, the Nayika seeks her lover. Oh Sakhi, for those in search of their lovers, night turns to day, darkness to light. Even the forest becomes easy to cross.
ऊंचे पहाड़ों पे सैया जी का गाऊं, काबे से मिलने को जाऊं, सजनिया कोई जतन बतिया दे। ऊंचे पहाड़ों पे सैया जी का गाऊं, काबे से मिलने को जाऊं, सजनिया कोई जतन बतला दे। Thank you.
Vasak Saja. The Nayika prepares for her lover. Prodha Dheera Dheera. The mature Nayika openly expresses her anger. Mukta Kalhantarita. The Nayika has quarreled with her husband. The Nayika does not appease her husband. She speaks not to her sakhis. But when the sandal-scented breeze blows, she feels an emptiness within. Ati Vishrabdha Navoda, the trusting Nayika. Prodha Adhira. Rati Priya Pragalbha. This mature Nayika delights in love. The night flies in lovemaking. Drowsily, he inquires if the sun has arisen. The Nayika hastily covers the ears, as if to keep the morning away. Dheera Jeshta Kanishtha. Madhyama, the Nayika lovingly scolds her lover. Two Nayikas. Parkiya Pravatsyat Patika, the Nayika anticipates separation. For your sake, I have trodden on snakes, disobeyed elders, lost all discretion. Now you will depart, leaving me to the tortures of all hells. Two Nayikas and Krishna. Vipralabdha, the neglected Nayika. The Sakhis led the new bride to the bower. The emptiness was stifling. She could neither stay nor leave. She gazed at the Kadamba grove, buzzing with hungry bees. Krishna waits outside the palace for Nayika. Abhisarika. Thank you. These are unmarried Nayikas. Sakshat Darshan. Oh mind, give up your playful ways. Oh eyelids, open wide. Oh Lord of love, forgive me. Lord Krishna is here. The poetry of Bhanudat and the paintings of Rasmanjari have perhaps never been surpassed in their delightful play of passion, their exploration of female sentiments and sensations, the total surrender of Radha to Krishna, or of human love to divine love.